In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of myofascia, which is around chest area, that is clavipectoral fascia. Clavipectoral fascia. This fascia covers anterior part of chest, like this. This fascia covers rib cage and pectoralis minor. This fascia attaches to clavicle, rib cage, sternum, basically this area. I'm going to explain its anatomy, myofascial connection, and relationship with other tissue. By the way, this fascia attaches to rib cage. What happens when this fascia gets tight? That can inhibit movement of rib cage. What happens if rib cage is inhibited? That can decrease function of breathing, right? Because it attaches to rib cage. That makes sense. So, clavipectoral fascia is one factor that can inhibit breathing. Okay, this is very, very important. Plus, this fascia covers pectoralis minor. This muscle is very important for shoulder movement and scapular movement. I don't go too much detail about pec minor. I just want you to know this muscle gives huge effect for scapula and shoulder movement. Clavipectoral fascia can affect breathing and scapular shoulder movement. Very important. Now let me explain its myofascial connection. Again, clavipectoral fascia covers chest like this. By the way, this is deep to pec major, okay? Now, clavipectoral fascia goes this way, attaches to clavicle, right? But it goes via fascia of subclavius. Fascia of subclavius, it fuses to subclavius. Now, this myofascial connection goes to posterior part of clavicle, okay? Clavipectoral fascia, fascia of subclavius, and it goes to posterior to the clavicle. Now, it can go up, go up, go up, like this. This fascia covers four muscles, that is, infrahyoid muscles. Infrahyoid muscles. That includes four muscles. So if you follow myofascial connection, you can go like this. Clavipectoral fascia. Fascia of subclavius. Posterior to clavicle. Then infrahyoid muscles. That means when clavipectoral fascia gets tight, it can affect movement of clavicle, and it can tighten up neck muscles. Vice versa, when neck muscles get tight, it can inhibit movement of clavicle and movement of chest because of this myofascial connection. Plus, this fascial connection can go to axilla and humerus. Clavipectoral fascia becomes fascia of axilla. Then this myofascial connection goes to fascia on arm. You see this myofascial connection? From clavipectoral fascia, it can go to neck. And it can go to upper extremity. That is why this fascia is very, very important. Now, let me explain relationship with other tissue. So, clavipectoral fascia has relationship with subclavian vein. Subclavian vein. Let's review myofascial connection again. Clavipectoral fascia. Fascia of subclavius. Posterior to clavicle. Now, at this area, posterior to clavicle, subclavian vein and this myofascia have relationship. They are very, very close. So, when this fascia gets tight, that can decrease blood flow of subclavian artery, right? Plus, I want you to remember, clavipectoral fascia covers ribcage. That means this has something to do with breathing. When you breathe, your ribcage opens up, expands, right? When you breathe in, your clavipectoral fascia needs to stretch as ribcage expands, okay? As you exhale, as your ribcage shrinks, this needs to move together as well, right? Now, this expansion and shrinking movement continues to this area, of course, because this is one continuous structure. This area needs to expand and shrink as you breathe in and breathe out. Remember, this area has connection with subclavian vein. So, as you breathe in, breathe out, this movement can affect blood flow of subclavian artery. When clavipectoral fascia doesn't move, doesn't stretch out, this function can affect blood flow of subclavian vein because there is myofascial connection between this fascia and subclavian vein. That is why this is very important fascia. This myofascia is important for mechanical connection. Plus, it has something to do with blood flow connection. Very, very interesting and important place. Now, let's look at this myofascial connection from profile view. This is profile view. There is clavipectoral fascia like this. It covers pec minor and ribcage. By the way, there is pec major superficial to this myofascia, like this. Clavipectoral fascia is deep to pec major. Plus, this fascia covers pectoralis minor. It goes up, fuses with fascia of subclavius. It goes posterior to clavicle, and it goes to infrahyoid muscles. Remember, there is connection with subclavian vein around this area. As you breathe in, clavipectoral fascia needs to expand and shrinks. This movement affects subclavian vein. This can help blood circulation for subclavian vein. It goes up, goes up, goes up to infrahyoid muscles. Also, this myofascial connection can go to axilla and upper extremity. This is very, very important. But not many anatomy books do not describe detail about clavipectoral fascia. So I hope this video gives you more broad prospect of myofascia around chest. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.